radical, radical, radical. Rush, rush, rush. Let's see if I can get this completed and done and uploaded before midnight. This is a product review for Debrox Earwax Removal Aid. Full transparency, I bought this with my own money. It's about $5. This is not a review copy. It'd be kind of weird, like, if it's a review, not copy, you would say that with video games. It's a review item. What would I clean out the wax and send it back full of wax? I had an issue a couple weeks ago, and I didn't know what to do, so I went to get this. I remember I'd used it years ago for a similar issue. I had an earwax buildup, and if any of you have ever had that, it's incredibly painful. Impacted earwax, you do whatever you can. Sometimes you just wiggle your ear a little bit and it loosens it up, but mine was bad. So I used this. I don't have any action figure around to actually give you an example of how you use this, but basically what you do is this solution. You tilt your head in one direction and you take the solution, and whatever it recommends, I think maybe 5 to 10 drops, you know, you just, you know, drop it in your ear. And I, for about 10 minutes, let's say this is me, I just kind of laid down, you know, with letting it pool inside of your ear. Now, it'll feel weird. It will feel really weird, but it's working. You'll hear some crackling, you know, and it's loosening it up. Now, after that, very important, what you want to do is take this bulb syringe. I think that's a technical term. Oh, that's relaxing. This bulb syringe, you fill it with some lukewarm water, and you lean your head over the sink, however you want to do it, and squirt some water, lukewarm water, in your ear. Now, don't jam this all the way in your ear, okay? Do not actually insert it in your ear. Just kind of like put it around the edge, you know, and just like, you know, just like however way you want to do it. But very important, just be careful not to jam this in your ear. And in general, a lot of people say, Rick, cotton swabs. No. I don't use cotton swabs. I don't use pens, pencils, you know, anything to stick in your ear to get stuff out, okay? Don't do that. That's messed up, all right? Do not do that. That could really damage your ear. Let's say you slip and you cough, you know, and you jam this in your head and, you know, you got brain matter coming out when you pull it back out. Okay, so don't do that. Don't do that. If you got earwax, if you got a buildup, use this. It pretty much, you know, and I would say an hour, I had to keep like flushing with this a little bit over an hour, and my problem was pretty much solved, you know. Well, by the next morning, I would say all my hearing came back 100%. Now, this thing kind of like, this could have dual uses too. This could have dual uses because let's say you're constipated, you know. You know, use it as a suppository, right? Now, here's what you don't want to do, though. If you're using it for dual use, you don't want to, you know, jam this up your hole, the number two hole. You don't want to jam this up your hole and take care of that and then, you know, flush out your ear. Because that's, you know, that would be making a different problem, because then you'd get shit in your ear, right? And then the next day, that'd be kind of embarrassing. If, you know, you were leaking shit out of your ear, you'd have people saying, hey, man, you know, you can't hear me today? Get the shit out of your ear. And then you tell them, I got the Debrox Earwax Removal Aid, and I thought I took care of my problem last night, but now I have a new problem.